retards with a bunch of brain flushers for creatures, and they haven't figured out that this thing is for real and that we are in a war.
Every forging kills a gap. Every tank kills a gap.
Something is definitely wrong. Something wrong.
Monkey, tracker, Yankee boys, if you haven't figured out that you've got enemies, you've got problems.
This is all Soviet anti-American stuff, and this is right. The anti-Semitic, the anti-Jewish, and the anti-Arab.
For the last 5 years, I've been traveling the world, collecting and studying the images that nations create of their enemies. My hope has been that if we had a better understanding of the way we think about enemies, we might be able to think of more rational ways of settling conflict. Here's a theme. The enemy is greedy. Now, look at that. Germany and Japan, and Japan swallowing the world. And then here, the Soviet... The first thing that caught my attention was that all nations use basically the same visual metaphors, the same hostile cliches, to characterize and dehumanize their enemies. It's as if all these propaganda artists had gone to the same art school. The enemy is always a demon. A barbarian, the aggressor, a liar, a madman, or some vile animal that can be exterminated without regret. Before we make war, even before we make weapons, we make an idea of the enemy. Every society has its official images of the enemy. But how do these images affect the individual? Because it is always the individual who has to decide to kill. What takes place in the mind and feelings of an individual that allows him to kill an enemy?